Hello everyone, welcome to Rapture. Today I'm going to be teaching you how to put 550 paracord into your Around Square Titans. Now, I have made this video once before, not long ago actually, but throughout the week I've done this, I've sort of strung up my Around Square Titans a few more times with 550 and picked up on a couple things and started to realize like there's more tips that I can give you guys that I left out of the first tutorial. excuse me. My voice is a pony right now because it's a little horse. Haha, I get it. Terrible jokes, love them. So yes, and also come to my attention that you know Mitch Muscle Bones, shout out to him. He's given me a lot of tips, how to do certain tricks. He's helped me a lot. Great tutorials on his YouTube channel. But yeah, he's one of the people that I sort of made this tutorial hoping that they would see it and get some 550. In their Titans, and he did. He was able to get his 550 into his Titans, so that's awesome. But he mentioned that he was burning his fingers in doing so. So I have a way, obviously, of preventing that from happening that I forgot to mention. So I'm gonna add that in here too. Anyway, before we get started, also want to give another shout out to Jagormly, as I did in the first video. I don't want to take full credit for this method. Because I did learn a lot about doing this from him. I just sort of added my own twist to it to make it a little bit easier for you. So yeah, shout out to him. Hopefully I didn't massacre his name. But yeah, let's get started. So just for reference, this pink paracord, I just want to show you guys you don't need an excessive amount for this, even though method might seem a little wasteful. This pink paracord came with my Around Square Everyman beads. So this is a standard length around square paracord that would come with the Everyman beads or the Titan beads, whatever you have. And this white piece of paracord, this white piece of 550 that we're using today, is just about the same size. Excuse the guts, pulled those out prematurely. Just about the same size, not including the guts, maybe even a little shorter. So this is plenty, and that's all you're gonna need. So let's get this pink out of the way while we do this, and let's get started. So to do this, what you're gonna need is a lighter. This is my mini torch, but a regular lighter will work just fine. A pair of needle nose pliers, some scissors, obviously your Titans, and this little guy is not completely necessary, just a bigger pair of needle nose pliers. Not completely necessary for putting them together, for stringing them up, but I will show you what that's for in a little bit. So yeah, let's get started. The first thing that you want to do is, well, this side is burnt, so I'm going to snip this off so it doesn't interfere. So yeah, this side is wide open now, no burnt end. So we're going to go over here, and we're going to pull out the guts, the inner strands of the paracord, from the sort of cover. I'm going to pull it out. And about that much should be good, maybe about 2 inches. Come over here and sort of feel that this side is now empty. You know, that didn't come through quite far enough for me. So we're going to go ahead and do that a little bit more. Yeah, so now this side of the paracord is empty. There are no guts in this side of the paracord. What I like to do is take my lighter, carefully sort of burn this open end and squeeze it together. Now I'm used to this, I've done this a lot, but to prevent yourself from burning, you know, you might rush in and grab this and it's really hot, it'll stick to your fingers, sort of like melted plastic. But to prevent that, you just want to take whatever fingers you're using, you know, your index and your thumb, your index and your middle finger, whatever, and lick them. Kind of gross, make sure your hands are clean, but lick them. And when you sort of go like this and you pinch them, it'll cool it down instantly. You might even hear it sizzle. But it also, it kind of helps get it nice and smooth as it cools down quicker. It'll help get that jagged edge a bit smoother. Not that that's really important for this end. This end, we're just sort of, I don't want the guts of the paracord to move while we're doing this. So I want them to stay in place. I don't want them to pull out any further. So yes, anytime you go in and reach for this burnt end, I might not do it because I'm used to this, but you just give your fingers a lick so they're a little moist, and then that way you don't burn your fingers. Sort of like, getting your fingers wet and squeezing the wick of a candle. You can put a candle out that way. I don't recommend it. Don't try that at home, but it does work. Great. Now you guys are curious, and you're gonna go try to put a candle out with your licked fingers. Don't blame me when you get burnt. But yes, now that we have this side of the paracord empty and gutted, now what we're gonna do is you're gonna take your scissors and you're gonna slip the blade of the scissors inside of this sheath of paracord, inside this empty paracord, and you're just gonna snip it, and you're gonna snip it up to where you can feel the strands that are still inside of the paracord. So that's a kind of a lot for me. Maybe might not need to do it that much. Pulled my paracord out a little bit too far, but that's all right. I'm just gonna go ahead and snip this off so it's not so much extra hanging around. And that's what I have now. Maybe an inch and a half of gutted paracord that is cut open. Again, take your scissors and you're gonna snip this material here, about a third of it. You don't want to do too much, so you're gonna sort of ruin the integrity of the paracord, and it's just gonna, tear as you're doing this. Do not pull on this too hard. I did that in my first tutorial and it fell apart on me, so not yet. Do not pull on this very hard while you're working with it. But you're gonna take this sort of half sheath of paracord and just kind of squish it together. Try to roll it onto itself. And of course, I did it again. I tore it in half. So, yay me. Be very careful when you're doing this. So, that figures I would tear it in half right after I warned you guys to not tear it in half. But, so, yes. Just very careful with this. And we're gonna heat it up. And you'll notice it sort of shrivels as it melts, which is good, as a good thing. And you want this to be as smooth as possible. The goal here is to get both ends of this paracord to sort of stick together as it's melted. So we're gonna do that a little bit more. And there you go. As you can see, I got those sides to stick together, so it's no longer open, it is reclosed. It is much smaller, about half the width of the full-size paracord, and there are no guts inside that. So again, just to get this as smooth as I can. The smoother you can get this, the smaller you can get this, the easier this is gonna be. And I'm hoping that, as opposed to the first time I did this in the tutorial, I still had a little bit of, I struggled a little bit still to get this through, and I want to give you guys a better example this time around. So again, I'm just trying to get this as smooth as I can, so there's no jagged edges. If there's jagged edges, they're gonna get caught when we pull them through the bead. So just smooth as you can get it. Try to get this end over here nice and pointy as well. That always helps. Roll it in your fingers a little bit, get it more round. And this part where the sort of full paracord meets the gutted paracord, you want to go a little bit past that when you melt it. That'll just help, strengthen this a little bit so that when we pull it through, it does not tear on us. Now that was a little bit hot. That would have been a good time to lick my fingers there. But I am all right. So yes, take your time. The smoother you get this, the more round you get this, the easier it's going to be to do the next step. So the beauty of this method is that we only have to do this complicated process to one side. You don't have to do it to this side. But what that means is we have to string these beads going on in the right direction, because we're going to string them on from this end. So the first bead, you're going to go in through the bottom of the bead and out through the top. Hopefully this is better than last time. Yes, that's much better than last time. Check that out, guys. 550 paracord straight through. There are no concerns there. Straight through the top of the bead. Beautiful. Now we're just going to take this, and again, this is where your pliers come into play. You can take these and just grip this guy and pull it through. Be careful here. Try to get to, you know, as soon as that full edge of the paracord comes out, that full-sized paracord still has the guts in it. It's much stronger than this melted edge here. So as soon as you can grab onto that, as opposed to grabbing onto this, you know, get some leverage on it, that's when you go and pull that through. Then now you can do this by hand and just pull it down. I'm gonna go ahead and just pull it down and tie off my knot here. I do recommend just a simple knot. No need to do the double overhand. If you do the double overhand, it's very difficult, if not impossible, to fit the knot inside of the bead. So unless you want your knots hanging out everywhere, be my guest. But I recommend a simple knot here so we can fit it inside of the bead. And I'm not going to pull that through just yet. I'm going to leave that for later. But this is just in case, so this bead doesn't fall off while we're working on the other end. And then this bead, opposite, you're going to take the paracord and go through the top of the bead and out the bottom. So, boom. Now that one's getting stuck a little bit. It's not quite as long, but that's perfectly fine. That is why we have this. So that paracord, I could probably get it with my fingertips if I wanted to. But again, just for the sake of demonstration, take your needle nose pliers, smallest ones you can afford to get in there, and grab them. Whoop. Grab it sort of as deep in there as you can. Again, just to get more leverage on it and not rip this off. A good pair of tweezers might work as well. It's going to be a little harder just because these pliers have like sort of grip on the inside of them that really helps to get a hold of that paracord, and because of the texture of the paracord, it's really not going anywhere once you get a solid grip on it. So unlike the first tutorial that I made, I'm going to go ahead and actually string these all the way up now. So there you go, paracord is on there. You can stop watching now if you want to, please don't, but paracord is on there now. That's what you came here to learn, and that's what you learned, hopefully. So yes, I'm going to go ahead and just pull that on all the way through. That is flush enough for me. So this one's good. Now, since this is a simple knot, it's more likely that it's going to slip out. You know, you're not going to fall apart. But to prevent that, we're just going to melt this end, finger a lick, and sort of press it onto the knot. So that, ideally, I mean, this gets thicker, like it sort of flattens out, and it makes it harder for that to slip through. What I like to do is sort of melt the edges of the knot to the end of that paracord. So there's just no way. Like, the end of the knot is melted to the actual knot itself. It's not coming apart. So it's kind of ugly because it's white. But there you go. That knot is completely hidden inside of there. And I'm not going to worry too much about my string length here. I'm just going to wing it. I'm very picky with my string length, but I can fix that later. For the second tutorial, again, same thing here. And you're not going to have to worry about this ugly end. We're just going to cut that off. So, make that knot nice and snug. Make sure that's going to fit. Yeah, that's going to fit. So, again, same thing. Snip that guy off pretty close to the knot. Melt it and sort of smash it into the knot itself. There you go, that's not going anywhere. Boom. So there you go, guys. That is a set of Titans fully strung up with 550 paracord. Now, you're probably wondering what this giant pair of pliers is for. Well, not giant, but much bigger than this one. So, this is going to be some tips actually on how to take these knots out. Because you might notice that once you get them in there, they're pretty stuck in there. That's why I recommended doing only a single knot. I really don't think you're going to get a double overhand knot inside of these beads. So, I did notice I was trying to unstring them, and it's really hard. And I don't want you guys to do this. So, warning, probably I should have said this earlier, but warning, you're taking a risk of getting paracord stuck inside of your Titans. But that is why I'm here with these guys, to just give you some tips on how to get them out. So there's no way you are sort of pushing that back out with just your bare hands. Highly doubt you're going to be able to get it with your fingers. And these might work, depending on how big your knot is. These might work to get them out, but it is tough. It's tough. So that is where these come in handy. The more surface area you have on these guys, the better to grip with. So get the sort of biggest pair of pliers you can fit inside the beads, at least to reach the string, and boom, it's that easy. No trouble whatsoever. So yeah, it's kinda a pain that you need a tool to do this, but again, get the biggest pair of pliers that you can manage to fit inside your beads. Boom, no problem at all. Now, as far as adjusting your string length, if you make them too long, it might be a little harder to pull that knot through when they're fully strung up. So unfortunately, if they're really stuck and you really can't get them out, another tip, I'm not going to do that now, I don't want to waste my paracord, but another tip, if they're really stuck, grab your scissors, get them as close to that bead as you can, and snip it off. It's sort of, at least in, it feels as if it releases a little bit of the tension here, and loosens that side up, and should make it a bit easier. Reach in there, grab the paracord, and pull it out just like that. So there you guys go. Again, warning, you may, two things, please don't burn your fingers. You're just giving your fingers a little lick before you touch that hot paracord, really helps. And don't squeeze onto the paracord forever, just sort of tap, and so you don't get your fingers too hot. And another thing, forewarning, you do risk getting paracord stuck inside of your Titans when you do this, even with a single simple knot. But hopefully you have a nice pair of thick pliers that'll still fit inside those beads. Shouldn't have any trouble getting them out. So yeah, there you guys go. That is how to string up your 550 paracord on your Titans. And hope you guys enjoyed this tutorial. Hopefully you guys learned something. So if you did, please like, comment, subscribe, and come back for more. Thank you guys very much for watching. I really appreciate it.